So in the previous videos, we talked about multilayer perceptrons. And as we work with these large neural networks, we also require large amounts of data. In this video, we will cover data loaders and how we can get the data into the network efficiently. So previously, when we worked with perceptrons and the logistic regression model, our data loading looked like as follows. So we iterated over the epochs, and then for each batch in the epoch, we loaded the data, let's say X for the features and Y for the labels. And then we fed that data to the model. So for each batch, we feed the features X to the model, which then produce the predictions. And from the predictions, we compute the loss. And the loss is then backpropagated using dot backward, so that we have the gradients with respect to the weights. And then we can call the step function to update the weights. So here's an example of how that looks like in code. So again, we iterate over the epochs, and then we load the data for each mini batch. And then we feed these inputs to the model, where we then apply the loss computation, followed by backward, and followed by the optimizer.step function, which will do the gradient updates of the weights. So conceptually, there's nothing wrong with this approach. This is really how our mental model works. We iterate over the epochs, and for each epoch, we load the mini batches, feed them to the model, and so forth. In practice, however, this creates a bottleneck. So if our data loading takes a few seconds because we have a large data set that doesn't fit into memory anymore, then our data loading takes also a few seconds, which will be the time where we have some inefficiency here because the model is waiting for the next batch to be loaded. So to make this more efficient, it would be nice if the mini batches are preloaded so that the model never has to wait until it receives the next mini batch. So in an ideal world, we want the data loading and the model training in two separate processes, because then we can have the data loading preparing already the next mini batch for the model, which then receives these mini batches to compute the loss without having this waiting period where the model is waiting for the next mini batch to be loaded. So conceptually, this would look like as follows. We have process one, which is the model training process. And while this model is training, the data loader is already in process two, preparing the next mini batch. But how do we implement that in code? It's actually pretty easy because PyTorch provides us with some very convenient functionality. So in code, all we need is this train loader, which is an object based on the data loader class in PyTorch. So this train loader will, in the background, prepare the next mini batches when we iterate over it while the model is training. So here's an example of how we can initialize the train loader for the training dataset. So don't worry about the details yet. We will cover these in more detail in the next video. However, I want to highlight one aspect here, and that's the number of workers, which we set equals to 2. So if we set the number of workers equal to 2, there will be two background processes prefetching or preloading the next mini batches so that they are ready when the model is ready to train. And just in case you are curious what drop last means here, so I'm setting drop last equals to true, and I usually do that only for the training set. So this will actually chop the last mini batch if our data set is not evenly divisible by the batch size. But again, we will cover more of these details in the upcoming video. So in this video, we covered the motivation behind data loaders, namely that we want to have background processes running the data loading while the model is training. And in the next video, we will dive more into the details of how the data loader and the datasets work in PyTorch.